Hello, this is Gary Schnitkey, and this is a 5-Minute Farm Doc Daily dealing with our county background, payments, and perspectives for corn. We are reviewing our county as debate for the next farm bill heats up. Our county was changed in the 2018 farm bill, which runs from 2019 to 2023. That farm bill gave three options for receiving commodity title payments. They were PLC, price loss coverage, ARC, agriculture risk coverage at the county level, and ARC at the individual level. Most farmers select PLC and ARC, and over the life of the farm bill, PLC has declined in use from 75% to 39%, and ARC County has increased. That has a lot to do with the rising prices that have occurred over the life of the farm bill. PLC is a price support program, and ARC County is a county revenue program. Those revenues are based on benchmark yields and benchmark prices. The five previous yields lagged 1 year enter into the benchmark yield calculation. The five previous prices lagged 1 year enter into the calculation of the benchmark price. For 2023, the benchmark price is $3.90, and that has increased from 2022 when it was $3.70. The $3.90 price is based on prices from 2021 going back. In 2024, that benchmark price will be much higher because of higher prices entering into the benchmark price calculation. Over the life of the farm bill, PLC made payments only in 2019, and that occurred because the $3.56 price was below the reference price of $3.70. On the other hand, our county made payments in specific counties in each year. In 2019, roughly 35% of the counties in the nation received our county payments for corn, and they were spread out. In Illinois, counties in the middle part of the state receive payments because of yields being lower because of wet weather during spring. In 2020, there were payments in the western Great Plains as well as in Pennsylvania through North Carolina. In 2021, again, we saw payments in the western Great Plains, North Dakota and South Dakota in particular, and also in Minnesota. Those areas were hit by drought. As we look at these payments and think about things, low revenue typically is a better indicator of stress than low prices. Low prices can sometimes be made up by higher yields. As a result, our county is better at targeting areas of stress rather than PLC. If we look back at those payments in 2019 through 2021, there were payments in all those years, even in the years when PLC did not make payments. As we move forward with debate for the next farm bill, we suggest making changes to our county, either increasing the guarantee level or perhaps increasing the payment range. Either one of those changes is likely to have more risk management beneficial impacts on corn farmers than changing PLC reference prices. You can read more about this in the FarmDoc Daily linked in the video description.